Yo, Big Shaq, the one and only. Man's not hot, never hot.
If Clangers could talk, he'd be on Clan Radio Live.
2 + 2 = 4, -1, that's 3, quick maths. Everyday man's on the block, smoke trees. See your girl in the park, that girl was a uckers. When the ting went quack, 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 you man were ducking. Hold tight, ask me, my brother, he's got a pumpy, big ting. Hold tight, my man,
my guy,
he's got a frisbee. A trap, trap, trap on the phone, moving out cornflakes. Rice Krispies, hold tight, my girl Whitney. On the road doing 10 toes, like my toes.
Like my toes.
You man thought I froze. I see a pen girl on a post.
Chilling.
If she ain't on it, I post. Look at your nose.
Check your nose, man.
You donut. Nose long like garden hose. I tell a man's not hot. I tell a man's not hot. The girl told me, take off your jacket. I said, babe, man's not hot.
Never hot.
I tell a man's not hot.
Never hot.
I tell a man's not hot.
Never hot.
The girl told me, take off your jacket. I said, babe, man's not hot.
Never hot.
Hop out the four door with the 4-4. It was 1, 2, 3, and 4.
Us, man.
Chilling in the corridor.
Yo.
Your dad is 44. And he's still calling man for a draw.
Look at him. Look at him.
Let him know. When I see him, I'm gonna spin his jaw.
Finish.
Take man's Twix by force.
Take it.
Send man's shot by force.
Send it.
Your girl knows I've got the sauce.
Flexing.
No ketchup.
None.
Just sauce.
Saucy.
Raw sauce. Yo. Boom. The ting goes. Skiddy kick. Pop. Pop. And the pop pop. Boom. 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 Skia. I tell a man's not hot,
man's not.
I tell a man's not hot,
never hot.
The girl told me, take off your jacket. I said, babe, man's not hot,
never hot.
I tell a man's not hot. I tell a man's not hot,
never hot.
The girl told me, take off your jacket. I said, babe, man's not hot. Man can never be hot,
never hot.
Perspiration ting,
spray that.
Lynx effects,
come on.
You didn't hear me, did you?
Nah,
use roll on,
use that.
Or spray.
Shh.
But either way, A, B, C, D.
Alphabet ting.
The ting goes. You done know. Big shot. Man's not hot. I tell a man's not hot.
Never hot.
40 degrees and man's not hot.
Come on,
yo. In the sauna. Man's not hot.
Never hot.
Yeah. Skiddy cat.
This is Clan Radio Live.
I can pay for everything that's on you. So everything is on me. Got them girls going Cindy Lauper, got Garv and a little blondie. If you ain't drunk, then you're in the wrong club. Don't feel sexy, you're on the wrong beach. Tell the bar that we don't want no glass, just bottles and a bite and everybody want each. Yeah, so bring the verb, click out. Think about it, hit the big 3 out. Party like it's carnival in Rio. Life's too short, they need to be out. Yo, we live, we die, we give, we try, we kiss, we fight. Also, we can have a good time, yeah.
I'm in it busy looking for the next top model. Who's wearing something new and something old and something borrowed. I know this crazy life can be a bit of pills to swallow. So forget about tomorrow. Tonight, we're drinking from the bowl.
As long as they ain't getting it wrong, then everything is alright. Got them girls going high, the cream, the Kardashians, the general types. If you ain't leaning, you're in the wrong scene. If you ain't hiding, you're not on my vibe. Tell the bar that we don't need no sparklers or nothing, just keep the bottles coming all night. Yeah, so bring the verb, freak out. Think about it, hit the big 3 out. Party like it's carnival in Rio. Life's too short, they need to be out. Yo, we live, we die, we
is he looking for the next top model? Who's wearing something new or something old and something borrowed? I know this crazy life can be a bitter pill to swallow, so forget about tomorrow, tonight. But if you can come to drinking from the
Plan Radio Live with Craig Anderson and Jerry McLaughlin.
Yo, coming in with a sound fresher than cut grass.
On the start,
second up we enter if you must ask.
Rush past, like you've forgotten your mind.
All the drivers all up in the face like, can I see a bus pass? But nah, we just want a little wine, bruv. Call me what you want, but you should not call it a night, love. And I might just join a mile high club. Only problem being that I couldn't give a flying.
Yeah, let me touch back down.
I'll slap her on her bum until it
comes back round.
Half the room's like, oi, what's this all about? With the other half jiving.
I love that sound.
What? Yeah, yeah.
I love that sound.
What?
Yeah, yeah.
I love that sound. So flick your back butts out once on a mad one. Like, yeah, your mama can't hop. And we're gonna burn some calories right here, right now. Ain't over till a fat boy slims, mama. Yeah, your mama can hump.
Mama do the hump, mama do the hump, hump. Mama do the hump, mama do the hump, hump. Mama do the hump, mama do the hump, hump. Mama do the hump, mama do the hump, hump. Mama do the hump, mama do the hump, hump. Let's get ready to rumble.
Let's get ready, ready, let's get ready, ready, let's get ready to rumble.
Watch us wreck the mic, watch us wreck the mic, watch us wreck the mic, psych.
Let's get ready.
Clan Radio Live.
Grooving. We can get you grooving.
This track's booming.
It ain't no hype.
Watch us wreck the mic. Watch us wreck the mic. Watch us wreck the mic. Psych.
Let's get ready to rumble.
Let's get ready to rumble.
Get ready, get ready, get ready, and rumble. Everybody rumble. Let's get ready to rumble.
Let's get ready to rumble.
Get ready, get ready, get ready, and rumble. Everybody rumble.
Let's get ready to rumble.
Sit back, rap attack, don't take no flack. Rhyme in time to the rhythm of the track.
I'm Ant.
I'm Declan.
A duo.
A twosome.
So many lyrics, we're frightened to use them.
So many lyrics, we'll keep them in stores.
We've even got them coming out of our pores. Your father.
Your mother.
Your sister.
Your brother.
Everyone's got to be an AKA lover.
Give us the motivation, we can cause a sensation.
Give us the aspiration, we can cause a sensation.
Give us the girls top speed.
Give us the girls stampede. Style and smile and everybody buck.
I'm the cat with the bass and drum, going around like bum bum bum.
Clan Radio Live, the voice of Glasgow's Greyhair Clan.
I'm the cat with the bass and drum, going around like bum bum bum. What's grooving? I'm moving. I like your style of lumping. How charming, just a rapper. Load him up and eat that snapper. I was 16 pints of rum and then I go bum bum. Blowing up in the dark in a night and so I go. I brought a pie in my pocket, pie in my pocket, and I am a singer. No got life, no got style, no got nothing on my mind, but I'm so cool and I'm so groovy. When I go bum bum bum,
Epics, how you doing?
Not too bad, how are you?
Yeah, not so bad. Ready for a bit of Laser Quest?
Yeah.
You up for it?
Yeah, a little excited, yeah.
I love lasers, don't you? I don't even know what they are. I don't even know what lasers are, but I love them.
Well, actually, Jerry, laser stands for the light amplification by stimulated emission of radiation.
Didn't have to go and ruin it, did you?
Let's go.
Sake.
Hi, I'm Craig Peacock, number 71 for your Brayhead clan. I describe my playing style as a two-way centerman. I like to be responsible in both ends of the ice, try and be good on face-offs, and contribute on special teams, whether that be the power play or the penalty kill, but just be a good two-way centerman for my team.
Peaks? 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 Are you? Peaks? Come on, man, stop fooling around. Come on now. Come on, you don't need to hunt me here. Come on, dude. It's just an interview. You're taking it too serious.
I'm coming, Jerry.
Who's going there?
Sick. Where are you? Where are you? Where are you, damn it?
Grenade.
Boom. What? Oh. Sake, man! This is supposed to be a Christmas special.
Sorry.
Sake. Unbelievable. Well, thanks very much for that, Peaks. Like I said, that was supposed to be a Christmas episode, and I think you took that far too far.
I play to win. Play to win.
Yeah, if you're not cheating, then you're not trying. That's what hockey player. That score line is not true. I think you've been shooting my gun.
I think
when
it's
went
right.
Back in the holster. That's unbelievable. Anyway, just wanted to have a wee quick chat with you as well, because it's interesting. I always usually start when we're talking with imports about how they got into hockey, and a lot of them obviously guys are from Canada. You've got a slightly more different route into hockey, although similar in a way. It was your dad that really got, as a hockey player, got you into hockey. Was that always destined for you then, when you were growing up in Peterborough?
I think so. My dad is Canadian, so I have that similarity with the imports there, and he played professional hockey for quite a while, and he ended up settling in Peterborough and met my mum, and my mum's brother actually played ice hockey as well, and they played on the same team together. So I think ice hockey was always destined for me. I mean, it was on my mum's side of the family and my dad's side of the family.
Wow.
So I was at the rink from an early age.
So you had that hockey DNA early doors. Was there any other sports that you played growing up? Was there anything else that you wanted to do, or was hockey always what you felt, if I can make a career out of that, I'd do that?
I played every sport there was growing up. I used to play football, obviously, being from England. I did play quite a bit of football when I was younger, and played for the school team and the local team, and then kind of got to the age where I was about 10 or 11, and you know, ice hockey was starting to take up some more time, so I had to choose what I wanted to do, and ice hockey, it was always ice hockey for me.
For what point for you did you realise that you could actually make a career out of it, though? This is something that we've been talking with a lot of guys about. There's one thing, it being your passion, but there's another thing, being able to be, this could support me, this could be a career for me. When did you know that was the case?
I'm not really sure. I mean, when I was younger, 17, I went across to America. And I think when I was sort of at that age and I was making that decision to leave home, and you know, I did quite well over there, it kind of clicked to me that, you know, I might have a chance to do this for a while yet and do it for a living. So that's why I made that decision to move over to America and get more ice time and try and better myself as a player.
So obviously that was a fantastic opportunity. How did that come about, and what was it like for you being a Brit playing a North American sport? That must have been quite unusual. You must have been one of the only Europeans, let alone British people there.
Yeah, well, funnily enough, there was my friend Michael Farn. He was in America the year before. I can't remember how he ended up over there, but he suggested to the coach that they bring over me and Robert Dowd, who plays in Sheffield. So yeah. the year I went over, there was three of us. There was three English guys over there. And it was great. I mean, it was a life-changing experience for me. I was 17 years old and moved away from home for the first time, and you get billeted out and live with a family over there and a player on the team. So that was, and I lived in Florida too, so.
It's not so bad then, is
no,
it?
No, really? So I spent about 9-10 months in the sun. So
similar to Peterborough, or?
A little different, it's yeah. A little different, yeah. But no, it was a great experience, and the fact that I had, you know, two of my friends over there with me, it made it a lot easier, because it was a big decision at 17 to move so far away from home and you know, be away from friends and family and everything I knew, but I had two friends there with me, so it wasn't too bad.
Do you think that's a good thing for hockey development? Obviously, there's a lot of people work really hard in the UK, developing UK talent. You've been involved in that scene as well. Do you think, though, that this opportunity to go abroad and to learn it, you know, at the home, you know, of hockey, do you think that's something that should be looked at from UK teams and UK development teams?
Yeah, I think you're starting to see a lot of kids now. Them, you know, they need to go and get as much ice time as possible and the best coach and can possibly get. But it's also a shame, you know, that they're having to do that, they're having to make that step to move away to a different obviously, you know, they need more ice time and more coaching. So you know, if you can find a way to improve that for the juniors and they don't have to start moving away, you know, that'd be a great day for British hockey. But, you know, for now, if you have that opportunity to go, I'd say definitely do it.
Well, obviously stood you in good stead, because you also didn't stay long. You came back to the UK, but didn't stay long in England. It wasn't long before you were over at the Belfast Giants, and you were there for a long time, 7 years for the Belfast Giants. And you had some cracking season there as well as top Brit as well. And how did that kind of come about as well? I mean, you had a bit of a breakout first season, really, didn't you?
Yeah, I was playing in Peterborough, and it was Rob Stewart in Belfast. He had sort of coached in the league that I was playing in before, and I guess he gave Belfast my name, and they came to watch me one game in Bracknell. I remember pretty nervous in the game. I knew I had people there watching me, and I think I probably had the worst game of the season. And I was like, well, that's that one gone.
He's actually quite good, yeah. Other than.
And just kind of went from there, and then ended up signing a contract and spent 7 years.
I mean, because obviously you play centre a lot for the Brayhead Clan now as well, but you were out in the wing a lot that time as well, weren't you? For Belfast, you did play some centre stuff, but it was out in the wing really was your forte.
Yeah,
and playing on the line with all those imports as well at that time, that must have been a big change for you. Did it suddenly hit you that this is a very, very different level?
Yeah, I mean, I remember the first week of training camp coming from, you know, the EPL, where we had four imports on the team, and then suddenly I was on a team with 10 imports, and I just remember the first practice, the pace of it was just another level, and I was like, oh, I'm gonna have to really work hard here. But you just adjust to it, you get used to it quickly. And we had a really good group of guys that year, and you know, I'm still friendly with a lot of them now from my very first season, and they made it easy on me being a young guy, and you know, really helped me along the way. But yeah, the pace was a noticeable jump when I first got there. But like I said, it was 10 imports in the league then, so I got a chance to play sort of second line and power play minutes, which I think really helped my game and put me where I am today, because I just got the chance and they threw me in the deep end, and that was it.
And Belfast, like a great city, obviously not just the opportunity to be playing in North America would help your hockey, but also being away from home beforehand would maybe make a move like that much easier, like going to another big city within the UK. That must have helped as well. Did you settle into Belfast quite quickly?
Yeah, I did. You know, people over there are very friendly, and it was really easy transition. Like I say, I went away when I was 17 to America, and then the following year I went to Canada. So I was kind of used to being away from home. It wasn't a big culture shock for me. It wasn't, you know, the first time I was leaving. It was the first time I ended up living by myself, so I had to figure out how to cook and clean and do all that. I didn't have my mum or my billet family around to help me with that one. So that was about the only thing that I had to get used to.
So then obviously comes the time where you make that switch away from Belfast Giants over to Brayhead Clan. I don't think many people maybe saw that move happening. Can you tell us a little bit about how it came about, who contacted you first, and how much of a decision that was for you?
I just kind of got in contact with Gareth, and Gareth reached out to me, and I was coming to the end of a contract in Belfast actually. So I'd spoke to Gareth and he expressed a little bit of interest in Brayhead. And for me at that point, I'd spent 7 years in Belfast and I just felt, you know, the time was right to have a change. You can get a little bit stale and if you stay in the same place too long, I think. And for me, I was just ready for a new challenge and sort of a new outlook on the game. And, you know, Brayhead, I watched them when they first came into league and they grew and grew and grew every year. And it was always a fun place to come and play and just sort of the conversations me and Gareth had. And then obviously speaking with Ryan when Ryan was a coach here and liked everything they had to say and it seemed like a good fit.
Yeah, and all around that time as well, being involved in the Team GB setup, it's changed a lot over the years. There's still some similar faces around, but you've been involved in a couple of pushes, very close to getting that gold medal, and then finally it arrived.
Yeah.
And obviously a current Clan teammate as well, Brendan Brooks, there with you on the line as well. Tell us a little bit about that tournament. That must have been a fantastic, to finally get your hands on that gold medal.
Yeah.
It's been coming, hasn't it? It's been coming.
Yeah, that was something really special. That was probably one of my favourite moments of my career. We the 2 years previous to that, we were in Croatia and Holland, and we got the silver medal. You know, we did really well through the whole tournament. We got to the final game. I think both years we just needed 1 point, so we just needed to get to overtime. That's all we needed, and we ended up losing both games by a goal. So for that to happen, it was just, you know, it was gutting, to be honest. Like it's the worst feeling, and we had it 2 years in a row. But you know, it really was third time lucky for us. And the special thing is as well, you know, we did it on home ice, so it was kind of nice. I mean, it sucked that we had to lose those 2 years, but then to finally get it and to get on home ice, I had my family there and my partner there, her family, and that was really something special.
Yeah, it was a great location for it as well. A couple of guys added to the roster that year as well, a couple of the dual passport guys. Mm-hmm. Brendan Brooks obviously being one, Liam Stewart being another. Do you ever kind of go like, oh, you guys suddenly get to jump on and get a gold medal here? I've been grinding this one out. Or were you like, cheers for helping, guys. Yeah. You did really well there.
No, they were both great additions to our team. And we made sure to give them their initiation anyway. They had to, we were driving back. I think we practiced in Milton Keynes one day, a training camp, and we were driving back to Coventry, and they had to get up at the front of the bus and sing God Save the Queen. So,
did they do okay with that? Did they know the lyrics?
Know, Brooksy did really well. Yeah. Brooksy did really well. He took control. Stewie was he was a little off. He was a little behind. He was trying to, I think he was reading the words off his phone there, but... no, Brooksy was great actually. He knew all the words and he bailed it out. So,
great.
Yeah, it was good fun.
So, it's been good times. It's been building up as well. Having another good season as well with the Clan. Obviously, injuries have held things up, but things start really well for the Clan.
Yeah.
You enjoying your time here? Could you see yourself staying at Clan for a longer spell? Obviously, you ended the contract in the first place. Would that be something you'd be keen to do again?
Yeah, I think so. You know, it's a great place to play and the team really look after you, the organisation look after you. And, you know,
everything. You get free Laser Quest.
You get free Laser Quest. No, but yeah, I think it's always going to be that way. Sort of few weeks, we found our and we're starting to show that.
That certainly is starting to show. Well, long may it continue, and I hope you score a few laser beams in the coming season. Cheers, man. Yeah. Sorry. That last line.
Clan Radio Live.
Hot and dangerous. If you're one of us, then roll with us. Cause we make the hipsters fall in love when we got our hot pants on and up. And yes, of course we does. We run in this town just like a club. And no, you don't want to mess with us. Got Jesus on my necklace. Turn it up, that DJ, turn it up, that
DJ, turn it up, that
DJ, turn it up,
Clangus could talk, he'd be on Clan Radio Live.
Yo! Big Shaq, the one and only. Man's not hot. Never hot.
If Clangus could talk, he'd be on Clan Radio Live.
2 + 2 = 4, minus 1, that's 3, quick maths. Everyday man's on the block, smoke trees. See your girl in the park, that girl was a uckers. When the ting went quack, 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 you man were ducking. Hold tight, ask me, my brother, he's got a pumpy, big ting. Hold tight, my man,
my guy,
he's got a frisbee. A trap, trap, trap on the phone, moving that cornflakes. Rice Krispies, hold tight, my girl Whitney. On the road doing 10 toes, like my toes,
like my toes.
You man thought I froze, I see a pen girl on a post.
Chilling.
If she ain't on it, I post. Look at your nose.
Check your nose, man.
You donut. Nose long like garden hose. I tell a man's not hot. I tell a man's not hot. The girl told me, take off your jacket. I said, babe, man's not hot.
Never hot.
I tell a man's not hot.
Never hot.
I tell a man's not hot.
Never hot.
The girl told me, take off your jacket. I said, babe, man's not hot.
Never hot.
Hop out the four door with the 4-4. It was 1, 2, 3, and 4.
Us, man.
Chilling in the corridor.
Yo.
Your dad is 44. And he's still calling man for a draw.
Look at him. Look at him.
Let him know. When I see him, I'm gonna spin his jaw.
Finish.
Take man's twix by force.
Take it.
Send man's shot by force.
Send it.
Your girl knows I've got the sauce.
Flexing.
No ketchup.
None.
Just sauce.
Saucy.
Raw sauce. Yo.
boom. The thing goes grrrr. Pop, 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 pop. Skitty key, pop, pop. And the poop, poop, grrrr. I tell a man's not hot, man's not. I tell a man's not hot, never hot. The girl told me, take off your jacket. I said, babe, man's not hot, never hot. I tell a man's not hot. I tell a man's not hot, never hot. The girl told me, take off your jacket. I said, babe, man's not hot. Man can never be hot, never hot. Perspiration ting, spray that. Lynx effects, come on. You didn't hear me, did you? Nah, use roll on, use that. Or spray, shh. But either way, A, B, C, D. Alphabet ting. The ting goes grrr. Skitty keep pop 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 and the poop poop boom boom boom. Skia do 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 boom boom. You done know. Big shot. Man's not hot. I tell a man's not hot. Never hot. 40 degrees and man's not hot. Come on, yo. In the sauna, man's not hot. Never hot. Yeah. Skitty cap pop.
This is Clan Radio Live.
I can pay for everything that's on. Yeah. So everything is on me. Woo. Got them girls going Cindy Lauper, Gargar and a little blondie. If you ain't drunk, then you're in the wrong club. Don't feel sexy, you're on the wrong beach. Tell the bar that we don't want no glass, just bottles and a bite and everybody want each. Yeah, so bring the verb, click out. Think about it, hit the big three out. Party like it's carnival in Rio. Life's too short, they need to be out. Yo, we live. We die, we give, we try, we kiss, we fight. Also, we can have a good time, yeah.
Good evening from a sellout Brayhead Arena. It's Brayhead Clan against Five Flyers on Clan Radio Live. I'm Craig Anderson taking you through the action tonight live from Glasgow. Five Flyers are in town fresh after that 3-2 overtime win against the Clan last night in Kirkcaldy. Will the second part of this doubleheader be every bit as exciting? We certainly hope so. Always great games between Brayhead and Fife. Both teams converging around their respective goals there for the last bit of instruction before the puck drop tonight. Referees tonight, Chris Wells and Alan Craig. They'll be assisted by the linesman Neil Gilroy and Colin Connor. Team news for you. Fife are only missing Reese Cochran. And Brayhead Clan without Josh Greaves and Kale Tanaka and Ryan Petulny from their lineup tonight. Great to see a big crowd here in Brayhead Arena tonight, on a Sunday night as well. Not something we see too often, particularly on a Sunday night. Certainly going to be a good game between these two, it usually is. And with Five Flyers enjoying bragging rights at the moment, victory in all four competitive matches against the Clan this season.
Ladies,
they'll want to make it five, that's for sure.
Girls,
anyway, if you want to get in touch with us, let us know where you're listening from, how you think the game will go. Get in touch with us on Twitter at Brayhead Clan using the hashtag ClanRadioLive. We'll read out the best of them. Meanwhile, the referee Alan Craig gets ready to drop that puck. And we're underway. Five Flyers win the draw on that occasion. Ross Moyer. Fife shooting left to right from our position. That's the Zamboni end to the Wall of Fame end, to give you an idea of the positions of both teams. Clan wearing purple tonight, Flyers in their white jerseys. It's an early chance from Schofield. Isles covering. That is near post. Hammerline in, Brooks. But LeBlanc in the way, just down the inside right. Burt has it, neutralised, feeds it down the left side. Powerful along the rim. Hammerlinen picks up just next to the half boards at the Five Flyers bench. But the Flyers bring it away. Plenty of singing from both sets of fans in the early stages. Liam Healis now in possession for Fife, coming up the right hand side into the centre. Just rolls off Ryan Knight. Needed a bit of help to control it there. Hammerlinen helping out there, and Knight eventually covering. 51 seconds on the clock played already. Well, that was another big result for Fife last night. They are currently fourth place in the Elite League table. Great for them. 40 points from 27 games. They've got games in hand as many as 6 over Sheffield Steelers, 5 over Belfast, 4 over the league leaders Cardiff Devils. They're enjoying a great season at the moment, the men from Kirkcaldy. As Fife retrieve the puck inside their own zone. Bring it forward, bring it to the right-hand side. But Shaber lays it off for Gauthier. He's chasing, but Oslanski just in front of him, up against the boards. In the corner on the opposite side, Shattuck works hard. And now Seskon leaves it off to him, back to his left. And Gauthier picks it up loose. Back in Fife ice at the moment. As Ricard Berzin's in possession, just dumps it into neutral ice. And pick up again, McKenzie. Gauthier in his face, takes it away from him. Good chance from Gauthier. Knight just does enough to take it wide, but now Clan on the break. It's him back, not got a lot of options. Ends up just feeding it diagonally. McKenzie looking to arrive late, but it lands in the glove of Andy Isles.
The safety and enjoyment of your fellow
well, as I say, 3-2 for Fife last night, that victory in Kirkcaldy, making it 4 in a row.
Is in open play. Always
Carlo Finucci and 2 Thank from Evan Bloodoff, including the overtime winner. The goals that got them the points last night. And they're going well in the Gardner Conference as well. Flyers win the draw again, Jorgensen. Feeds off to Wands, and again, Peacock just inside the blue line. But really can't do anything with it as the Flyers again look to break forward. Jorgensen down the left-hand side, looks to feed it into the centre. Couple of purple jerseys in there, move it away, but Finucci now retrieves the what looked like a lost cause, in fairness, on the right-hand side. Needs to play it back to Jorgensen. He's in a more neutralised position now. It's Isaacs to Ian Young. And Fife Ice just playing it D to D across the zone. Again, Stockton down the right hand side, off the pad of Knight, and Finucci inside the blue line on the left hand side. Now Clan have it, good foul to Brace. Brace, who got the goal that took the goal game into overtime last night. Haywood lays it back just inside the blue line. The wrist shot coming from Adam Brace, and Isles making the stop. This is Clan Radio Live. Fife Flyers coming to Brayhead Clan tonight in Elite League action. 0-0 so far. 2 minutes 48 on the clock played so far. It's 4th against 8th in the Elite League table. Clan have lost their 2 games in the new year. Good shot there from Adam Brace. Bit of a one-timer. Just past Andy Isles' left-hand post. Brace feeds it forward to Haywood. Clan look to try and catch them out quickly. Haywood plays it into the centre. Isles attempts a swipe at it, but it's Healis retrieves up the right hand side. Works well with Peter LeBlanc. But Haywood cuts out the pass, and it's Cameron Butt in possession. Home fans appreciating that bit of play there. Good defensive work. Sullivan on the far corner in front of section F at the Wall of Fame end. Burt now behind Ryan, nice goal as he looks for an option. Just feeds it off for Schofield. Schofield with that blistering pace. Brooks inside, comes to Hamalainen. Hamalainen has to do a bit of work first, tries to turn it to the outside to get away from Shaber. Not quite successful on that occasion. Goes all the way out to Oslanski at the blue line. Deflection takes it wide. Hamalainen back to Brooks down the left-hand side. Oslanski tries to feed it in. Brooks on the turn, just tries to sweep it forward, just wide. Fife having to do a bit of defending, and they do so really well. 5-0, Brayhead 0. In front of the sellout crowd here at Brayhead Arena tonight. Well, Clan, if anything, will be looking for something different than the last time Fife were here. Hembach tries a sweeping one, a diagonal effort. And then Oslanski in a wide position, testing Isles at his near post. Into the glove. As I was just saying there, Clan, the last time Flyers came here, a 7-1 victory for Fife Flyers here. And they went on and won the 2 meetings after, both in Fife. It was 5-1 Flyers the week after, and then 5-2 the week after that one, back in October. And of course, the game last night. You've seen the Fife Flyers come away with all points so far. Now they look to break up the far end. Charlie Mosey Big Siskun just getting his body in ahead of him. Again, the Flyers recover it. Inside the blue line now, it's Jorgensen inside to Mosey. And back as Clan look to bring it the other way. Shattuck, Russ Moyer takes it off him. Good experience from Russ Moyer, but now Shattuck has it. Again, tries to drill it in at the angle. Isles covering it well. Nearly 5 minutes played of this first period. Clan 0, Fife 0. Big night for both teams. Leon Yost has tweeted he's listening from Kirkcaldy and he reckons an overtime win for Fife tonight. Sarah L's on a train. She says it'll be interesting. And my kingdom for a non-YouTube feed. Well, we hope you get the reception you're after, Sarah. Play continues now as Russ Moyer just ties up McKenzie over the far side there. Buessa in there to help out the youngster, Jordan Buessa. Works hard against the boards there on the far side in front of Section 8. Just at the scoreboard end of this arena. But again, the Flyers doing well defensively to bring it out of the danger zone. Finucci and McKenzie clash. But that puck goes loose again. Clan having to really dig it out from the boards there. Tommy Muir helping things out. That's a good effort, hit the post. There's Fife again. It was James Isaacs with that chance. I don't think Ryan Nye too much about it, but Finucci now up the right-hand side. It's Fife again, Ricard Berzins plays along the blue line of the Clan for Moyer. You can sense there's something building, the Fife fans finding their voices. Berzins, good play from him, tries to feed it in low, takes the deflection, takes it over, Gutwald. Feeds it on for the Clan. And the whistle goes. And shouting for an extra man. The penalty doesn't come though.
For the projectionist. And tonight, our winner is over in Block B. Block B tonight.
I'll make a look to everybody who's listening this evening.
Is in seat number 7.
Wherever you are, I hope you're listening to the game and enjoying it so far. 0-0 between these two teams. Finally poised at the moment. Still plenty of time to go, of course. 13:42 remains of the first period. As Moyer feeds it along to Jorgensen along the blue line. Two experienced D-men, of course. We've won honours in this league. Brayhead, the home team. Move it forward, it's Haywood coming up from their own zone. The high pass from Bray, Shattuck has to bring it down with his hand, does so. He's in the Fife zone now. Laid in, Brace couldn't quite get anything on it. That was a stinger of a chance from Burke, goes over. Hits the glass and comes back. Sullivan has to retreat back into Clan ice. As Haywood helps him out to Burke down the left-hand side now. Cameron Burke moves into a more central position. Makes entry into the Fife zone. Lays off to Shattuck. Haywood back to Siskun, just inside the blue line, moves it to the left. Shattuck again tries to drive it across the crease. But finding his options limited, Siskun down the left to Shattuck. Shattuck turns. This is back, has to retreat. Siskun, one-timer, straight into the logo of Andy Isles. Good shot from the D-man. Well, this is a fixture. It's always served up a lot of entertainment, a lot of action in recent years as the rivalry has really cranked up between these two teams. Fife, of course, have been victorious in all games so far. Clan won 8 out of 10 in competitive meetings against Fife last year. So maybe getting a little bit back from last year. And Brooks just misses out there to Shaber. Tries something, ends up having to go wide as Clan recover well enough to defend that one, forcing the Fife forward into a wide position. But the Fife are still in control of it. Shaber in a right side position. Young tries one. Good work from Hamalainen there, diving to make the interception. Does so well, but now Charlie Mosey has it. He's up against the boards behind Ryan Nye's goal. The poke check from Hamalainen leaves it for Siskun. Comes down the right-hand side.
Only as far as Berzins, he plays it straight away back in. Now it's Sheba on the right hand side coming in to a central position. My fans not happy with that. That's a challenge from Oslanski. Shattuck, Doughty has it back to Shattuck again. Clan building down the left hand side. 11:35 to go this first period. Mbach makes the interception, turns from Mosey, it's Mbach. And you have to say that's great defensive work from Mosey, who brings it back out now of the Clan into neutral ice rather from Mbach. Getting a little bit tasty now, a couple of collisions in there. Bit of needle to them. That's Fife in the neutral zone. Coming across the central red line, Carlo Finucci just dumps it into Ryan Nye's glove in the end. Nye just moving a little bit forward to make that catch. 11:08 remains of the first period. Don Cummins listening from Kirkcaldy, hashtag we can do this. Another Fife fan getting in touch with us tonight. Not getting a lot of Clan fans on the Twitter. Get on here, tell us where you are, where you're listening, how you think the game will go. Use the hashtag Clan Radio Live on the Brayhead Clan Twitter account at Brayhead Clan. As play stops again, that face-off was won, but it was blown straight back. Shane Stockton into the centre. Alongside Mike Mbach. Fife win the draw, Moyer back to Finucci. Finucci fakes the shot, comes inside. The puck is loose right in front of Nye, bit of a scramble, but the home side get it away, it's Doughty. Just on his own blue line, just feeds it into the opposite corner
icing,
in front of section N.
Icing, sponsored by Goldstone Wealth Management.
And another icing call. Brayhead have the, well, the face-off is in their zone, to the right of Ryan Nye. In front of section F, the Wall of Fame end, which will have a new addition in it very soon. Matt Keith has announced he'll be the recipient of a banner on that wall. The former Clan captain, of course, once famously had a Fife Flyer scarf and binned it after his first season here at Brayhead. But now the home side come forward again, make the entry into the five zone. The pass was too long from Doughty. He was looking to play an end back, just a little bit too heavy with the pass. As the Flyers take control, Moyer brings it forward, Stockton down the right-hand side. Shane Stockton comes off the pads of Ryan Nye. Finucci almost followed up with a rebound straight away. Christopher Bjorklund was right in front of him. He couldn't really do anything with it. Pretty even game this so far, although I think a lot of the action has been in the Clan zone. As Fife look to make the breakthrough. Isaacs to Finucci down the right. He's just inside the blue line. The Clan defensive zone now. They have it back. It's Gutwald for Bjorklund. Forward to Buesa. Down the left-hand side, Buesa just dumps it into the far end. McKenzie. And it's Isles makes the cover. There's a bit of a push and a shove there. Young Buesa's involved. I don't see who the Fife Flyers player is involved there. Craig Peacock's come in to get involved. Barry McKenzie in there as well. Something and nothing, that little situation. Buesa dumped the puck just to the left of Andy Isles' goal as we look down here. But Jordan Buesa gets a big round of applause from the home fans. Brayhead Clan 0, Fife Flyers 0. 10:15 played of the first period in Elite Ice Hockey League action with Clan Radio Live. I'm Craig Anderson taking you through the action tonight here from Glasgow. Fife Flyers. The puck is in their zone. Clan win the face-off to the right of Andy Isles' goal. It's Burke now down the left side, tussling with Peter LeBlanc, who wins it. Just to feed it to Liam Healis. He's not able to get by the purple bodies. First Shattuck and then Matt Haywood, but blood off. Wins it back, Healis, number 74 for Fife Flyers. Sullivan gets in ahead of him. The D-man for the Brayhead Clan, Sullivan, in his fourth season with the club. That could have been a chance there. Gauthier tries to feed in LeBlanc. Blood off. Chance from Blood off.
caught by Ryan Knight. Bloodhoff is the man to watch, of course. Not only did he get two goals in that game last night, all season he scored 8 goals and provided 1 assist in games against Brayhead Clan. But he's not the top scorer in this fixture this season. That honour goes to Liam Healis. 2 and 8, 10 points from him. So they've got plenty of firepower, this Five Flyers team. They've got some big victories this year, and of course worthy of their position in the league at the moment. And the Five Flyers backing possession of the puck in their own zone. It's Moyer down the left side. Feeds it up into the boards. Gauthier chases. It's in the Clan zone now, but comes back down into neutral ice. Jorgensen back to Moyer. For Mosey. Mosey on the turn, just inside the Clan blue line. Shaver just turns and sweeps it along the backboard. Jorgensen's there. That touch from Oslanski just wide of the Clan goal. That was very nearly in his own net. The Flyers. It's Shaver. The effort from Jorgensen's pass there. Not quite getting the power on it he would have liked. Moyer moves it ahead, Shaver. Getting the touch on it, just takes it away from him, and the Clan captain, Ville Hämäläinen, down the inside right, just in front of the half boards, neutralise. And it's Bjorklund to Brooks, down the left now. Bjorklund at the boards. There's Fife. Get the stick in ahead, it's Moyer. Good experience from the number 26. Once again, the puck comes loose. That's Cameron Burt that has it. Just taking a few seconds to weigh up his options as both teams change around the personnel at the moment. Burt down the left for Shattuck. Shattuck's first touch, not so good. He has to chase after it. Tommy Muir covers him all the way. His plan, have to take it all the way back and go again. Shattuck retrieves it just in front of the blue line. Just on centre ice now. Is it back to Burt and to Embach? Embach goes to a central position. It's down the right hand side now. Doughty inside to Seskon. Burt down the left for Doughty. And tries to get it down that position, but Tommy Muir covers it all the way. Isaacs in neutral ice, feeds it wide. And Fife getting nothing on it. Not enough for Knight to make the cover. 7:01 remains. Elite League action coming to you from Brayhead Arena tonight. We'll get a roundup on some of the scores around the rinks as well at some point. But in the meantime, currently goalless. Section end drummer listening from sickbed. Keep up the good work. Keep chanting, guys. That's one of the tweets that's come in. Let us know where you are, where you're hearing the game, and how you think the game will go. Oslanski just gets in ahead of Liam Healis on the far side. Feeds it out to Brace, but Gauthier wins it back on the turn. Now he has it for Seskon. Just comes off the boards on this near side. And down into the far side, and that goes for
that's
icing.
Goldstone Wealth Management.
More tweets from you. David Horn listening from East Kilbride, hoping for a Clan win before we go back to work and school tomorrow. Amen, David, I hear you on that one. Starry One, come on Five, from cold Sweden. She's contacted us from Frölunda, lovely part of the world. Susie Russell, Susie and Keith listening from Burnt Island and Fife. Hashtag bring the noise, hashtag COYF. That's some of the tweets coming in from the fans. As we come to you live from Brayhead Arena, it's the Clan moving forward now. Brace tries one, hits the post and wide. As he come in down the inside right for the home side. But that puck is loose. Brace brings it away from Berzins. Has a look up, Brooks is in a central position. Has to play it back the way, the move doesn't quite come off. And the up and under lands with Oslanski in the Clan zone. But again, Fife battle hard to win it back. The pass for Brooks here from Brace doesn't quite go as
icing,
planned, and it's icing again.
By Goldstone Wealth Management.
With 5:50 to go. Well, Fife without Rhys Cochrane tonight, he's the only absentee for them. Clan without Josh Graveson, Kale Tanaka and Ryan Patilny. The absentees from tonight's game. Clan win the face-off on that occasion. But they lose it again. Fife have it at the blue line. It's fed up by Jorgensen looking for Sheba. Doesn't quite work for them. There's Lansky. As Sheba pinned up against the boards there, just at that Wall of Fame end, behind Ryan Nye's goal. And Sheba comes away with it. He's a real danger for Fife this year. Mosey back to Moyer at the blue line. Moyer feeds it back to Jorgensen. Jorgensen tries one. A scramble in front of Nye as Gauthier trying to get something on it. But the home side able to bring it forward. Brooks makes the entry into Fife ice. Brooks, good solo effort. Isles covers his near post well. And again, the Flyers just working hard there. Sheba blocked by Bjorklund. Sheba has to turn round, chase and get it back. Again, allowing both teams to make some changes to their personnel on the ice at the moment. Moyer to Stockton. Shane Stockton down the right-hand side for Nucci. And that's blocked. That allows Clan on a breakaway. Doughty comes down the inside right. The interception only goes as far as Embach. Embach in the far corner. Has to turn back to Gutwald. Gutwald couldn't get the shot away straight away. Blocked off by Stockton. Good work from the Fife forward. And again, the visitors making their presence known in the Clan zone. Isaacs trying one there. But Nye moves it on. Bjorklund now in possession for the Clan. Takes a deflection off Muir and goes behind. The men in purple still have it. Shattuck, that's an effort. As Isles moves it away. Only to his right. McKenzie makes the retrieval. McKenzie looking for an option. Just feeds it all the way back to the blue line. Sullivan not quite in the same wavelength. As that puck comes all the way back behind Ryan Nye's goal, Sullivan in possession of it. 3:45 remains of this first period. As Peacock glides in down the inside right, has to turn away from Jim Jorgensen. Jorgensen using his experience to get in ahead of the GB international. Jorgensen, of course, a former Clan defenceman, of course, played under Drew Bannister back in season 11-12. Blood off down the left-hand side for Fife, intercepted by Brace. Now Clan lose it. It's Healis. Is this an opportunity? Deeks inside. Good work from Ryan Knight. He makes the block. Healis deeks past Zach Sullivan. Saw the opening. Tried the low one past Ryan Knight. Ryan making the low save. And eventually blocking. Remains of the first period. Brendan Brooks against Chase Shaver in the face-off. Fife win it once again. Ian Young feeds it on to Mosey. Mosey down the left-hand side for Fife. Back to Young at the blue line. Looks to play it along the boards. Intercepted by Landon Oslanski. The up and under. Down into Fife ice. Schofield chases after it. Berzins gets sent ahead of him. Really giving him something to think about there. Sheba. Young leaves it for Mosey. Fife again looking to build from the back. Berzins. That's Gauthier. One timer from Sheba. Goes wide. And recover again. Hammerlinen. But it's cut out by Mosey. Just as Schofield was cranking up the gears a little bit. Sheba has it behind the Clan goal now. Comes down the left hand side. Retreating from the goal. But Oslanski takes it off him. Against the board, it's Brooks inside to Schofield. Schofield forced into a wide position, has to go back the way, back to Gutwald. Clan inside their own defensive ice at the moment. Bjorklund into neutral ice now, when it's cut out. And it's Gauthier for Healis. Gutwald down the right hand side now. Brayhead looked to build, but Moyer takes it away again. Feeds it along to James Isaacs. Healis leaves it back the way. Bjorklund, that's a high one.
into the net behind the goal.
Clan Pucks and we get another breather. Wet Wall Works. Please remember to keep your eye on the puck.
Well, just as a look here, Fife come into this game unbeaten in their last six. A great record they've got at the moment. They've lost only one in their last 13. They've won 11 of those games in those 13. They've drawn the other one. That was a 3-3 draw with Belfast Giants, against whom they'll play in the second leg of their Challenge Cup quarter final this week. That tie finally poised, of course. As we get ready to take the face off there, Andy Isles just getting a drink there. Tyler Shattuck's in the face-off circle, just at the hash marks. The face-off will be to the right of Andy Isles' goal. One-timer from Mbak as Clan win the draw. Bjorklund down the right, has to turn. Reverse pass looks for Doughty. Doughty has to chase after it, but he holds off Jim Jorgensen well. Mbak again going in. Jorgensen again doing some great work. Healis. Tries the pass, doesn't quite come off for him. Stockton was denied in that situation. As the home side move it forward, Mbak back to Gutwald. Clan make the entry into Fife Fife, but Berzins gets in ahead of Clan's 28. Doughty. As we're in the last minute, Healis. The goal was gaping there for Vernucci. Couldn't quite get anything on it there. That's a collective sigh of relief from the Purple Army you heard there. 45 seconds to go, and the Fife Flyers just willing their team on in the last minute or so, as Brooks tries to make the dash down the right hand side. Took a bit of a tumble there, it was a bit of a blowout with the skater walk, but no, he's still on the ice. Of course, that would have amused the away fans. Brooks, of course, played for the Flyers last year after leaving Brayhead initially. But goes D to D with Sullivan. Sullivan down the left-hand side, moves into neutral ice, feeds it wide to Hamalainen. Hamalainen inside to Brooks. But Young is there to deny the Clan number 49. As this first period will come to an end. And there we have it, that's the buzzer. And that signals quite an entertaining first period. No goals as yet. But it's been quite a... It's been quite a first period. Not a lot in the way of clear-cut chances, but I'm sure plenty for the coaches to mull over that opening 20 minutes. We'll take a little break just now. We'll be back in time for the start of the second period as my normal partner in crime, Jerry, gets ready to introduce a bath race. I'll leave you with that image, and we'll join you for the second period.
Wearing something new with something old and something borrowed. I know this crazy life can be a bit unwieldy. We're drinking from the bowl. Something old and something borrowed. I know this crazy life can be a bit unclosed to swallow. So forget about tomorrow. Tonight, we're drinking from the bowl. We're drinking from the
bowl. Can we be on say? We ain't gonna pipe that rap noise in. All of that cheesy stuff. Sweating it, busting the mic, slamming it, jamming it, to watch ya.
the mic, slamming it, jamming it, do what you like.
Welcome back to Brayhead Arena. You're listening to Clan Radio Live. As we're just about to join the action for the second period. Brayhead Clan against the Fife Flyers, currently goalless after 20 minutes. Quite an even first period. Just get through a couple of tweets for you from people listening in. Sharon Allison listening and cheering on the Fife Flyers in Kirkcaldy. Harry Chalmers, that name's familiar, listening at home in Washington. Sounds like a solid first period from the Clan, and says to say hello to Gareth for him. He is, of course, the father of Gareth Chalmers. A Brayhead Clan. Anyway, we're back underway for the second period. Fife win the draw, and the puck is stopped pretty much straight away for an offside call. So we've got time for this tweet from Ronnie Savickas, or Savickas, apologies if I've mispronounced that. He's listening from Glenrothes with his family. He predicts a 4-2 Fife win. Come on, Clan fans, get on the Twitter and let us know how you think this game will go. Tell us where you're listening from, and we'll read out the best of them through the course of the game. Clan win the draw now. It's Mbak. Tries one, comes off the pads of Andy Isles. And the visitors move it away. It's Healis, a backhanded pass for Bloodoff. But just a little bit too far ahead for Bloodoff, for Burke to just move it away from him. Doughty fires one in off the blocker of Isles, goes wide. Interesting to see how this period pans out. By all accounts, very similar to the first period in Kirkcaldy last night. Not a lot of great clear-cut chances, very even first period. Ended goalless, of course, we've seen that here tonight. So we'll see what the second period brings. Fife Flyers could go third place if they win here tonight. Clan will remain in eighth place. They are 7 points behind Manchester Storm, who are just above them. Storm, of course, are the Clan's next opponents here at Brayhead Arena next Saturday. Get those tickets at brayheadclan.com. Face-off is at 7 p.m. as Clan welcome back Ryan Finnerty and a few other familiar faces. Well, maybe not Jay Rosehill, who's currently suspended. Certainly Matt Becker, Scott Pitt, Mike Hammond, they'll be back in the Storm lineup. Anyway, Flyers try one. It's Young from the blue line. And Nye has to move it on with his pads. There's Lansky now. Has to turn away from Gauthier. Gauthier, though, gets the better of him on that occasion. Sheba just inside the blue line. Goes wide. Seskon makes the recovery.
sends it up the other end. Shaver helping out defensively for Ian Young. Comes off the boards just at the Clan bench end. Shaver back for Young inside Fife Ice at the moment. The visitors building things slowly. Mosey takes it and makes the entry into the Clan zone. Tries to swing it round Nye. Has to cover it as near post. Fife Flyers shooting in their position from right to left. That's the Wall of Fame end to the Zamboni end where the scoreboard is here at Brayhead Arena. Flyers wearing white, Clan in purple this evening. Well, as well as no goals in this game so far, we haven't seen any penalties either. Both teams have been at 5-on-5 all game so far. Good to see that throughout the game, although you don't get many games like that nowadays. Brooks just loses possession of the puck from Finucci. Stockton moves it around behind his own goal. That's Fife build from the back. It's Russ Moyer. Matt Haywood is all over him. Moyer, good turn. Just gets that bit of space to feed it onto Jim Jorgensen to his left. Stockton now down the inside left. Feeds it into the near corner in front of section end, but Christopher Bjorklund has it and sweeps it along the board. Moving forward for Schofield. Schofield sends it forward. Can Clan do anything with this? Brooks has to turn. Just keeps it inside the blue line. Cut out by Isaacs. And now Stockton. Entry into the Clan defensive zone now. Finucci tries one, comes off nine, goes wide. I think that looked a bit closer than certainly the reaction it got from the fans here. Again, Clan just solid in defence at the moment. Both teams are, you have to say. A very tight game at the moment. Well, it went to overtime last night. We can't really rule that possibility out. The last two Clan games have gone beyond regulation time. The game on Tuesday at Dundee Stars ended in 3-2 after penalty shots, and it was 3-2 again last night as Fife took the game in overtime. Embach, the reverse pass cut out again by the Flyers. It was Blood off there who got the all-important touch. Todd Dutiam's side. Shattuck on the turn. Isles had to divert it wide. Seskin keeps it alive at the blue line. Well, turns out that's not the case. Offside is called. Well, YMCA being played across Brayhead Arena at the moment. The break and play. 16-18 to go of the second period. Well, in terms of the conference, Fife topped that with 18 points from 10 games. Clan second with 16 points from 12. Fife looking to win the Gardner Conference for the first time on their bench. They've got a guy that's done just that. Jeff Hutchins, the assistant coach, won it with Dundee in 2014. One of three men to have won the Gardner Conference title. Three coaches, that is. Hutchins has won. The other two being Paul Gardner in his stint in charge at Brayhead, and Ryan Finnerty, who won it in his last three seasons as Brayhead coach. We'll see a different coach win it this year. Brayhead just send it up the other end.
That's and icing goes again.
Not much to report on in that situation. Referees tonight are Chris Wells and Alan Craig. The linesmen are Neil Gilroy and Colin Connor. 15:47 remains in this second period here in Glasgow. Fife Flyers can go third if they win here tonight. Neil Campbell is tweeting from Cadiz in Spain, but now Bloodoff tries to dig it in at the near post of Ryan Knight. Fife, that move came very slowly. Clan having to do a fair bit of defending here, but they get it away. And it's Seskon down the right for Brooks. That's Peacock. Feeds it along the backboards. Russ Moyer will take that gratefully. Just gets in ahead of Tyler Schofield. Well, Brendan Brooks trying to get the better of Ian Young as the puck moves to the far corner in front of Section F. Down that wall of fame end. Gauthier. Good skating and stick work from the Flyers number 78. Comes, makes the entry. It's Moyer with the shot. Now he makes the save. Fife have to move to avoid a six-man call. There's the puck now down the right-hand side for Brayhead. Brace has to turn, play it back to his defence. Mikael Gutwald is the man to feed it forward. McKenzie chase after. Five Flyers, the one team Barry McKenzie hasn't played for from Scotland in the Elite League. Finucci down the left-hand side for Fife, tries one. Into Nye's glove, it bounces out. That's a watch it very carefully. Now Clan on the break, it's Shattuck down the right-hand side, comes inside, sends the shot just wide. Just opens his body up and tries one. Isles is watching that one very carefully as the home side again look to build. Shattuck wants to get away from Ian Young. It's at the blue line, just in front of the Clan bench, Gutwald. And a bit of a scramble with James Isaacs, now Flyers. Build down the other side, inside to Finucci. What can Finucci do here? It's denied by Knight. And that's another save from the Clan goalie. Makes the catch that time. That was an opportunity. It was Ian Young with a follow-up. Young and Finucci collaborating in that instance. Young feeding in Finucci, Nye made the initial save. Young with the follow-up, Nye making the catch.
To enjoy a box of delicious Krispy Kreme donuts.
And a winner, their goal remains preserved. 13-43.
And our winner is in seat number 8. Congratulations.
Left of the clock in the second period.
You've won those delicious Krispy Kreme donuts.
And we're back underway again. This Clan managed to bring the puck away from the draw. The home side now, it's Burt. Has to turn back slightly. It does enough to feed in Doughty. Doughty's pass though. In back, picks up on the far side. Brayhead, it's Peacock. Lays off for Burt. Inside to Embach. Good work from Embach. Looks for Doughty in front of the crease, but Helis is there to bring it away. Moyer in neutralised. Fife make the entry on the far side. Trying to do something with this again, trying to scramble it in. That looked like a hit there. Now Doughty's hit has been called. That was on Helis. Now the hit happened right in front of Chris Wells, the other referee. Alan Craig called it from the red line, across the halfway line. He obviously saw something that Chris Wells didn't. And Doughty will take a seat for that one. The first penalty of the game is Jacob Doughty, with 7 minutes to go. And Clan, their first penalty killing unit is out in force there. Tyler Schofield is out there. Hamalainen in the face-off circle. Flyers with a power play opportunity. Done well in the power play this year. Doughty for Shaver. Back to Berzins down the left-hand side. Berzins back the way to Gauthier. Young back to Gauthier, tries one, goes wide. Fife looking to get this one in quickly. Of course, the winning goal in last night's game came on the power play. That came courtesy of Evan Bloodoff. Ian Young down the inside right for Fife Flyers now. As once again the visitors to try and pile the pressure on the home defence and the netminder. And we'll have to do well in the next 70 seconds to try and keep that goal unblemished. Young. It's caused a bit of a scramble, but McKenzie taps it out. Brooks has planned break. Brooks reverse turn, but Young takes it away from him. Good work from the 5D man. That could have been an opportunity there. Brooks thought he had the space there, but Young doing enough with his stick to poke it away from Clan's number 49. Now Gauthier, and at the left hand side, plays it cross ice to Berzins. It's back across to this near side as Haywood just gets in ahead of Finucci. Comes all the way back to Rossmoyer. 25 seconds of the penalty remains. Jacob Doughty sits for boarding as the Flyers make the entry into Clan ice. It's Finucci diagonally across, but Healis has to retrieve it at the board on the far side. LeBlanc just in front of the Fife bench down the right hand side. Back to Healis. Takes a deflection off Gutwald's stick and the penalty is killed. Jacob Doughty returns to action. 10:55 to go. You're joining us live. It's Clan Radio Live coming to you from Brayhead Arena in Glasgow. Live Elite League action between Brayhead Clan and the Fife Flyers. You're looking for a score update. As it stands, it's currently goalless, 0-0 between Clan and the Flyers. These two rivals going head-to-head for the second time this season. Fife have got 2 points from the game last night. Clan have won. We'll be looking to change that tonight. Make it a bit more even, Stephen. We will, of course, get the thoughts from John Tripp post-game. And Todd Dutiam, that interview will appear on Elite League Audio. That will be posted out later on Elite League social media. 10:34 on the clock of the second period. We'll get you an update on the scores around the rinks very soon as play's about to restart. Tyler Shattuck and Shane Stockton meeting in the middle there as Fife win the draw on that occasion as they move it into the centre. It's Finucci, chases down the inside right. He was fed in by James Isaacs. Isaacs now has it in. Stockton! The goal is gaping. Ryan Nye was committed and the Flyers have the opening goal. 10:17 to go of the second period. 29:43 on the clock. Isaacs feeding in. Stockton just in front of the crease. Nye was committed. The chance just before it just took him a little bit away. And Stockton was able to tap in from close range. And that's why the Flyers are a goal to nil up. You could hear the cheer from the Flyers fans in that corner there. 1-0 for the Flyers. Can they make it 5 in a row against the Clan this season? They would certainly like to think so.
For the Fife Flyers, scored by number 68, Shane Stockton, assisted by number 40, Carlo Finucci. Time of the goal, 29 minutes and 43 seconds.
Carlo Finucci opening confirmed as having the assist scored by on that goal.
Assisted by 40, time of the goal, 29:43.
Well, that's Stockton's third point against Brayhead this year.
Wall works. Please remember,
second goal,
keep your eye
Carlo
on
Finucci with the assist.
All times.
His sixth point against Brayhead, his fourth assist, along with two goals this year. Elsewhere around the rinks, Coventry 1, Milton Keynes 1. That started an hour later. Manchester are leading Guildford by 4-3 in the second period. Cardiff 4, Nottingham 1 in the second period. And just coming up to the end of the second, Edinburgh 1, Dundee 1. That's the latest scores around the rinks at the moment. As Peacock and Shaver come together on this near side down in the corner in front of section end, but Clan moving it forward. Buesa takes on the puck from Oslanski, dumps it down the far end, chases after it. As Clan look to send the bodies forward to try and get something on it. It's come down the other way. It's Mosey, the save from Knight. Mosey had Young in support, went himself. Forced a good save from the Clan goalie. Fife look for the second one. It's Gauthier. He had space just next to the hash marks. Looked up, saw the space just over Knight's shoulder. And the Flyers are 2-0 up. Well, a great opportunity from the Fife Flyers. Just over a minute after taking the lead.
Ryan Nye beaten on that occasion. Charlie Mosey had the initial effort saved by the Clan goalie. Play continued and Danny Gauthier stopped, looked up, saw where he wanted to put it, and he did so over Ryan Nye's left shoulder into the net, and the Flyers leading by 2-0. And those away fans in the corner absolutely delighted.
Greyhead
have called a timeout. So John Tripp bringing the troops in, having a quick word.
It's time.
Two quick fire goals from the Flyers have turned this game a little bit. It was very even up until the fifth goal.
By number 78, Danny Gauthier, assisted by number 7, Ian Young.
And Ian Young gets the assist on Danny Gauthier's goal.
28 seconds. Second goal for the Flyers, scored by 48.
Well, the joker and the thief is played. Try and get the fans, the home fans on side. Clan 0, Flyers 2, remember. Let us know where you're listening from. Hashtag Clan Radio Live. Whether you're of a Clan or a Flyers persuasion, we want to know who's out there, we want to know who's listening. Flyers will look for a third one. Bloodoff tries one from the left-hand side. Nye has to cover it at his near post. He's all the way back, Jorgensen now. Burt uses his foot to just move it away from the centre. And now it's Brooks. Makes the entry into the face. Plays it across. Isles just moves it on. Oslanski, Sullivan, neutralised, now feeds it forward into the backboard just in front of the Wall of Fame. Oslanski has it on the near side. But LeBlanc has it loose. His Clan try the pass, it doesn't come off for them. A bit more urgency about the Clan now since that timeout.
Do I play hockey? Well, I play air hockey ball, hockey bird, hockey ball, hockey field.
8:20 to go over the second period. As I say, as things stand, Fife will go third in the Elite League table. They will leapfrog Sheffield, who aren't playing tonight. They had that double-header weekend over in Belfast on Friday and Saturday. They don't play tonight. So that allows the other teams to get some points on the board. This Clan working hard in the Flyers' end. Shane Stockton sends the puck into the crowd.
Sponsored by Wet Wall Works. Please remember to keep your eye on the puck at all times.
And that will be a penalty. Not Stockton at all. The fans down there looking for some first aid assistance. Obviously someone has been hit with that puck. Ian Young takes the seat for delay of game. Hope the fan down there isn't too seriously hurt as we get the play underway.
Flyers penalty to be served.
Just inside the blue line, come forward. The one time effort from Oslanski goes wide. And now Flyers have their penalty killing unit out for the first time.
Number 7. 2 minutes
in this game.
Penalty time 32-01.
It comes all the way down for Ryan Knight. He just takes the sting out of it, leaves it for Cameron Burt. Coming up on 7.5 minutes left of the second period. Clan 0, Flyers 2. And Oslanski down the right hand side. He's got Peacock behind him. What's he going to do here? Along the back boards, comes all the way down to Shattuck, who's in front of the Clan bench. Now for Burt. Again down the left hand side. Looks up. Finds Schofield at the blue line. Schofield lays off Oslanski. Takes a couple of deflections and goes wide. And the goal comes off the mooring. Well, you can probably hear what the Clan fans think of that one. Can I kick it? 1:04 of the penalty remains. 7:02 remains of the period.
Can I kick it? To all the people who can press like a tripod. before this, did you really know what I was? Comprehend to the jackpot's why, cuz.
Play will restart on the face-off circle to the right of Andy Isles on our far side, in front of Section F at the Wall of Fame end. That's Isaacs. As Fife win the draw, just feeds it along those boards, but Burt is there to make the interception. Gutwald back to Embach. Gutwald now on the right-hand side, looking for options, looking for men in purple. Back to Embach at the blue line. Burt comes across. What can Clan do here? Embach tries to feed it in. He had Gutwald right in front of Isles' goal. Man from the Czech Republic doing his bit there, but now it's a chance for Flyers at Sheba. But ends up going behind Clan's goal, forced in the slightly opposite direction as they look to create something, but now the home side bring it forward again. Oh, power play, not really enjoying a lot of success. Fife stifling them at every turn. Oslanski down the right hand side, looks to come inside. Moyer does so. But he's now got blood off tracking him as he finds his way to the backboards. Ian Young returns to action. The opportunity from Brooks takes the deflection. And Fife again. As Doughty and Brooks collide, the Clan still have it. Embach inside for Oslanski. And again, Isles just doing enough. As Fife move forward again, blood off down the inside left, tries one. That was a chance just to the left of Ryan Nye's goal and wide. 5.5 to go. Shattuck down the right hand side. Inside to Brace. Brace making a timely move into the centre. He got the puck, just couldn't get the shot off. Now Shattuck. Clan have really upped the tempo here. A few chances in on goal now. He would try to go on the end of that Brace Turnland shot, but Isles had it covered. 5:06 of the second period remains. Clan 0, Flyers 2. Two good goals it was as well. Shane Stockton and Danny Gauthier with the goals. If you're just joining us. See the face off to the right of Andy Isles in front of Section F at that Wall of Fame end. Clan looked to up the ante again, hopefully get something on the board, something that'll maybe swing the momentum a little bit in their direction. At the moment it's Flyers at the moment who have that momentum, a two goal lead. They'll be looking to make it a third, make life a bit more difficult for the Clan. Puck comes all the way down the other end. It's Brooks along the blue line to Bjorklund. Makes the entry to Fife. Schofield just misses out on it. Taken away from him by Shane Stockton. Clan have it again. It's Brooks who called as offside. Maybe a little bit too quickly as they tried to make that move. Good evening to Babs Duncan, listening from Kennaway in Fife. I've been to Kennaway. Once had a friend that stayed there. Go Flyers, hoping to get another 2 points tonight. Rosalind is loving listening whilst at home. Come on, Flyers, make it a double win. I need to have a word with producer Stuart here. Let's get some Clan fans on here, Stuart. If you are listening, tweet us at Brayhead Clan. Use the hashtag Clan Radio Live. We'll give you a shout out through the game. Let us know where you're listening from, what you think of the game, how you see it going. Of course, you might have a fair indication of how the game's going at the moment. Flyers leading by 2-0. Well, that could change as the visitors strike it forward. That was a good chance. Charlie Mosey trying one. Shaber was in the centre, chose to go it alone, and Nye had to watch it carefully. Andy Isles skates out from his crease to receive acclaim from the visiting fans. 4:10 to go of the second period. Clan 0, Flyers 2. Two big Gardner Conference points up for grabs as well. Fife looking like a real difficult team to beat this year. As Gauthier tries one, it's moved wide by Knight. And again, a bit of a tussle in the corner here. Chase Shaber having to contend with Tyler Shattuck and Mike Embach. And the home side
Bring it away at Shattuck, leaves it back for Embach. Clan make the entry, it's Brace. Tries one, Isles does enough to divert it wide. As the men in purple having to turn and work hard just off at their bench there. Home fans ain't looking for a call there. Yeah, they're going to see one. Chris Wells' hand is up, there will be a penalty. Clan having the extra man on the ice at the moment, Oslanski into the centre. Deflection moves it away, Sesko now down the left hand side. Gun. It's got Shattuck behind the goal. Embach. Brace tries to make the tap. The tap in at the crease. And that goal has come off the mooring again. The play stops. And another penalty. 4-5. It's Danny Gauthier that will take the seat. That's a holding call. 3:07 remains of the second period. Clan get another power play opportunity. Well, there's certainly been a bit more urgency about Clan since that second goal. Number 79 is up on the scoreboard, that really should say 78. As Danny Gauthier is the man to take a seat. Clan with the man advantage, 5-on-4. Well, the Clan's next home game is next Saturday when they take on Manchester Storm. 7 o'clock face-off for the return of Ryan Finnerty and his men. First time they'll meet in the league this year. Tickets available, go to brayheadclan.com for all your ticket information for that game next Saturday. That's going to be a good one, that's for sure.
Flyers penalty to be served in the near Gauthier. Penalty box.
Gauthier's penalty begins.
78, Danny Gauthier. 2 minutes for holding.
Clan take penalty the face off as Burt now down the inside right.
Flyers penalty.
Comes inside. He's got an opportunity, tries one, it goes wide. That kind of opened up for him there, not a lot of five players trying to get in his way to stop him. That's Burt finding the space. But that's turned and swept away by Jim Jorgensen. Very experienced Jim Jorgensen, of course. A playoff winner with Coventry Blaze. And it's Craig Peacock back to Burt on this right-hand side for the Clan. Burt looks for an option. Shattuck and Peacock in front of Isles. The fans shouting for something here. Schofield. Peacock back to Schofield. Into the centre. Oslanski tries one, goes wide. Jorgensen just takes a heavy hit and gets rid of it. The minute's gone already of the penalty. Two to go of the second period. It's been an interesting game to say the least. Those two Flyers goals have certainly put a different complexion on it. Oslanski forced into the corner in front of those five Flyers fans at the Wall of Fame end. Once again, the visiting team bring it away. It's Moyer on the turn, intercepted by Oslanski. He gets stuck under his skate. His Clan looked to turn something around very quickly. It didn't quite happen for them. Oslanski looks up, looks for an option into the centre. It's deflected away. And Schofield has it just inside the blue line, down the inside right, looks up. Back to Burt, just at the blue line. Burt lines one up. Comes off the 5D man, bounces back out again. 5 seconds to go, Burt again. With a shot, it goes wide. And the penalty is killed. Gauthier back on the ice. As Brayhead now back in possession of the puck.
Second period.
Brace
1 minute
on the right hand side. Has to move inside, but just as they were changing the man, the puck is lost, but they get it back. They're in five ice at the moment. A lot from the Clan in front of the goal. They're not really putting a lot of chances on Andy Isles and forcing them into some saves. That urgency they had after the second goal, they really ranked up the pressure a little bit. That's kind of dissipated a little bit. Brooks tries one, goes wide, Brace, and the goal off the moor again. Again, the home fans not happy at how easily that goal is coming off. ...27.2 seconds remain of the second period. Again, it'll be interesting to know what the coaches are thinking.
Fife, I would have to say, quite happy with how it's going. Maybe not their best performance of the season, but they are doing more than enough in this game. Very solid unit, the Fife Flyers, scoring in all their lines. They've maybe not got players that are leading the charts in terms of scoring, but they make up for that with what the other lines put in as well. And when you look at the likes of Chase Shaber, getting plenty of goals and opportunities, Gauthier, Liam Healis, all around the late 20, early 30s point in terms of point scoring. And they're going very well. That was a chance from Oslanski from the right hand side, fed it in. Isles making the catch. Even Carlo Finucci's having a great season, 30 points from 27 games before tonight, 11 goals, 19 assists. Carlo, of course, come from Swindon Wildcats at the start of last season. As the puck drops in the face-off circle to the left of Andy Isles' goal, to our right, at the Wall of Fame end, and that buzzer goes. The Fife Flyers fans are on their feet cheering their team off at the moment, rightly so, leading by 2-0. Those goals coming from Shane Stockton and Danny Gauthier. Fife Flyers with a 2-goal advantage. We'll take a break just now, we'll be back for the third period. This contest isn't over yet, as the Flyers go in 2-0 after two periods.
Drinking from the bottle.
Angus could talk, he'd be on Clan Radio Live.
No ketchup, not just sauce, saucy, raw sauce.
You the Kardashians, you got the root ties. If you ain't lean, then you're in the wrong scene. If you ain't hiding...
As the Clan take on Fife Flyers, the Flyers leading back as quickly as possible. But it's an interesting one, 42.1 seconds before we start the third period. Alan Craig, the referee, in the centre, getting ready to restart things.
The Fife Flyers.
Flyers will go third.
And your home side, the Brave.
The score line stays like this. Keep your tweets coming. At Greyhead Clan on Twitter using the hashtag Clan Radio Live. As the Clan in possession of the puck straight away, Brooks tries one, comes off Jorgensen, deflects into the plexi behind the goal. Jorgensen has it now on the right hand side for Flyers. Schofield into the centre for Brooks, and the loose puck picked up there as Flyers look to move it forward. Liam Healis there
blocked by Cameron Burt. Comes all the way back to Sullivan for the Clan. Inside to Brooks, who just lays it on a little bit, allowing the line changes for both teams. A big third period for both teams, more so the Clan because of their losing position in the game at the moment. Those two goals around the halfway mark in the second period from Shane Stockton and Danny Gauthier. Changing the game, that was a chance from Young at the blue line, just goes wide. Comes all the way back to Young, who's now in neutral ice. Looks forward, just dumps it into the corner where the Fife Flyers fans are. And there's quite a number of them have made the journey here from Kirkcaldy tonight. They always make plenty of noise wherever they go, those Flyers fans. Dodson's, that's a hit from Shattuck. But Fife winning it back. Gauthier for Berzins. Mosey just outside the Fife defensive zone at the moment. Gauthier trying to create something, but a purple jersey just stopping him from making any impact. Comes all the way back to Sescon. Clan in defensive ice at the moment. And it's Gutwald down the inside left. Goes wider to get away from Shane Stockton. Gutwald plays it in. Tries to force it in at the far post, at the near post rather. Andy Isles basically had to slap it away with his blocker. Good work from the Fife goalie on that occasion. Well, big hello to Alan Crowe, the Fife Free Press editor and chairman of the Kirkcaldy branch of the Bruce Springsteen Appreciation Society, although I may have just made that one up. But let us know where you're listening to the game from tonight. Always good to hear from the fans. And it's Brayhead that win the draw. It's Gutwald. Cut out by Stockton. Looks to feed it forward. Intercepted by Bjorklund. And now, can they come forward again? Stockton makes the entry into Clan Ice. Isaacs, that's a shot. That's a big hit on Stockton. Looking for an arm of a referee. One doesn't go up. Stockton's come off worse there. Didn't really see who made that hit there. I was watching the play as it continued. But after Stockton played that pass, he crashed up against the boards on this near side. Fife fans not happy. Stockton skated slowly back to the bench. He'll get a little bit of attention. Brooks and Muir collide on this near side. Brooks maybe the shot, it goes wide. Clan now looking to up the ante a bit here. Zach Sullivan in neutral ice. Backhanded to Brooks, makes the entry on the left-hand side. Brooks inside for Hamalainen, just wide. And now Evan Bloodoff, the man with plenty of goals against the Clan this season. 8 of them to be exact. Tried one. That's got the fans on side anyway. Let's hope to see Stockton back on ice soon. He's a big player for Flyers this year. He's had his injury problems in the past, of course, but he's having a good season. 11 goals and 10 assists, that's 21. Of course, he's got a goal here tonight to make that his 22nd point of the season. Sescon, the deflection almost takes it past Isles. Isles, I don't think knew too much about it, but he did enough. As the Fife goalie makes the catch, 16:27 to go of the third period. Alexander Ritchie listening from Kirkcaldy, keep it up Flyers. Ian King listening from South Yorkshire, come on Flyers. All these Fire Flyers fans getting in touch, always good to hear from the fans of course. Sean Gordon's listening from Fife Ice Arena. He's included a picture of a telly with the both club logos on it, obviously tuned in to YouTube. Thank you all for listening. As play continues, it's Evan Mosey of course, of Nottingham Panthers, my mistake. Chase Shaber in possession, just moves away from Shattuck. Again, the tempo up in these early stages of this third period. Clan trailing by 2-0, of course. That's good work from Gauthier. Doing enough to line up the chance off the blocker of Knight. And lands behind the goal. Now there's crosswords here between Gauthier and Doughty. I just wonder if there'll be anything further from that one. To them having a chat anyway. I get the feeling it wasn't if they had a nice Christmas or what they're up to after the game. I just wonder if Gauthier's looking for something here. You're listening to Clan Radio Live, coming to you from Brayhead Arena. I'm Craig Anderson, taking you through the action tonight. Brayhead Clan against the Fife Flyers. The visitors leading by 2-0. As it stands, they'll make it a 4-point weekend and head into third place in the Elite League, which is quite incredible as they mix it with the so-called bigger budget teams in the Elite League. Cardiff, of course, top of the league at the moment. Belfast up there, Sheffield Steelers up there also. And you've got to give a big hand to Guildford Flames. They're up there also. They're in fifth going into tonight's games. We'll get another score check around the rink soon. But now Peacock brings it back for the Clan. Takes it around the Fife goal. Tries to get away from Ian Young in the process. Clan working hard. It's Brooks back to Sescon. Peacock now. Young shouts for a cross check. Doesn't come. Alan Craig not interested, the referee. That's LeBlanc. Fife move forward. That's an effort from Mosey. Goes wide. Goes all the way back into Fife ice at the moment. Keyless just lays it on. Personnel changes from both teams. Clan have the loose puck. 15 minutes dead to go. As the home side look for a way back into this game at the moment. Fife Flyers have been solid at the back tonight. Well, great experience they've got back there. Russ Moyer, Jim Jorgensen, Ian Young has been a star player for Fife this year. Good feature on him this week in the Fife Free Press by Matthew Elder. He's enjoying his a really good season in Kirkcaldy. Bjorklund. Almost a mistake, a turnover. Isaacs was straight in front of him. The two number fives coming together. Isaacs, though, not able to get a chance to create anything as Clan build forward again. Gutwald, Hammerlinen down the inside left. And it's dumped into Isles. Takes the sting out of it with the pads and covers. Other scores around the rinks at the moment. Coventry 3, Milton Keynes 2 after two periods. That was later in starting. That didn't start till 6:15. Manchester are 4-3 up against Guildford, 10 minutes into the third period. Cardiff 5, Nottingham 2, 9 minutes into the third period. Edinburgh and Dundee locked at one apiece with 3 minutes to go of that game in Murrayfield. Dundee looking for a 4-point weekend. Edinburgh looking for their first win in 13. Back to this game. Clan win the draw. Sullivan. It's fed in. The chance from Shattuck just goes wide. Doughty making a nuisance of himself. And he's going to take a seat here. Jacob Doughty, it's a slashing call for the Clan number 28. The home fans not happy with that one, as you can hear. Boos ring out around Brayhead Arena. So, Fife have a power play opportunity. Just looking at the goal scoring for Fife in their recent games. Evan Bloodoff has scored in Fife's last three games. Carlo Finucci scored three in the last, scored three of the last four games rather.
In the official supporters Moya. Sponsor penalty box.
Fife win the draw, they're going to use this power play to their advantage.
2 minutes for slashing. Penalty time.
As Peter LeBlanc comes in on the right hand side. Just stays in the wide position. Tries to draw in Schofield. Finucci has space.
Penalty time,
feeds it across.
56.
Now it's Healis having to double back. The deflection off Hammerlinen brings it back into away ice. Russ Moyer with the retrieval job. 1.5 minutes to go of this penalty. Healis, the turnover, just took his eye off it for just a second. Brooks was straight on it, makes the entry. Brooks inside, looks for McKenzie. Too far for the Clan forward. Comes all the way back now. It's LeBlanc down the right hand side for Fife Flyers. Looking to get a touch on it in the centre was Bloodoff. Doesn't quite happen for him. Fife now camped in and around the Brayhead defensive zone, looking for that opening. Healis turns away from Oslanski. Finucci just sticks to the hash marks. Now it's Moyer at the blue line. LeBlanc now jammed up on this near side, the right hand side, in front of those Fife fans. Fife shooting into the Wall of Fame end. Moyer tries a low one. Nye makes the block, sends it away. There's Finucci. Again, just retrieves it. But the high pass is too high. And Moya has to chase back for it. Moya was going to return to the bench there, but saw Haywood was chasing after it. Too many men. There's the shout from the fans there. But it doesn't come. As the Flyers, Berzins feeds it into the centre. Nye, away from his goal, uses a stick to send it along the board, only as far as Berzins on this near side. Gutvaldo has it back in possession for the home side. Berzins can't quite control it. Takes it back into neutral ice. And the penalty is killed. Jacob Doughty returns to action. And Fife not quite able to get the power play goal. Charlie Mosey just to the left of Ryan Nye's goal there, tried to line one up. Gutwald is there. Zins feeds it forward on the wide right position. It's against the boards on the far side opposite. And section F in the corner. The Wall of Fame end. A lot of play down to our right as we look down on Brayhead Arena. We're opposite the benches, of course. Fife is on our left, Brayhead on the right. Clan shooting into the Zamboni end. Shattuck to Burt. It's cut out. Sullivan has to turn and try and move it back in. Gauthier was right behind him. Well, the singing coming from the Fife Flyers corner here in Brayhead Arena. Blood off. Good work from him in the central position. Tries one. Wonderful save from Ryan Nye, making the catch, scooping it out of midair. Okay, that was a good opportunity. Bloodoff looking for his ninth goal against the Clan this season.
Winning ticket in our side stick raffle, it's a pink ticket. Pink ticket number 717. Pink 717. Congratulations, Bloodoff. If that's your ticket.
You got a hat trick in the first meeting here.
Please make your
way. 7-1 win for Fife back in October. He scored two last night. He scored two in the second of the two games in October in Fife as well. So he's certainly a player to watch for the Fife Flyers this year, Evan Bloodoff. But now the Clan burst forward again. Schofield makes the entry. Moves it to the wide right position. Has to get away from Jim Jorgensen. Backhanded pass from Schofield along the boards to Hamalainen. Cut out by LeBlanc. To feed it in for Healis, but again Clan having to start again from the back. Schofield to Sullivan, through into the centre for Schofield for Burt down the inside left. Burt tries one, a deflection off Chase Shaver's stick, sees it taken into the net
works.
Behind the goal.
Please remember to keep your eye on the puck at all.
Well, if you're just joining us, Clan 0, Flyers 2. Thanks for joining us here at Brayhead Arena. It's Clan Radio Live. Clan's next game next Saturday against the Manchester Storm. That's a 7 o'clock face-off. That's the 13th of January. As Ryan Finnerty makes another return to Glasgow with his new team. Tickets available at brayheadclan.com. The home side in possession. As the play gets back underway, it's Brace. Tried to play in Peacock. Didn't work out for him. Flyers. Now Isaac's taking advantage upon the Wall of Fame end, just behind Ryan Nye's goal. The away fans there, one or two on their feet there, expecting something to happen. Didn't quite work though. Didn't quite happen on that occasion. Isles, and it's moved away from the visiting team. Sheba tries to skip on the outside of McKenzie. Reads the challenge well. Brace. Shattuck comes down the left-hand side, inside to Brace. Brace tries one, blocked by Berzins. Brace still has it, but just loses possession of it at the wrong moment. As Bjorklund and Schaber come together on the far side, down the left-hand side from a Fife point of view. Berzins and Doughty. Another hit from Doughty on Berzins right in front of the Fife fans. They're not happy with that. Gutwald. Behind Nye's goal, now LeBlanc intercepts, comes up the left-hand side, turns to create some space past Bjorklund. The blue line is Jorgensen, he's got Berzins to his right. Berzins has it. They're working it around as though it's a power play, the Fife Flyers. LeBlanc back to Jorgensen. Gauthier with space, Gauthier! And it's blocked by Nye. And swept away by the Clan defence. 8:40 to go of this third period.
Goldstone Wealth Management.
Well, can Clan find a way through this very stubborn Fife defence? The home fans will certainly hope so.
We'll go to the holder of the following ticket, winning ticket number 010.
Just getting confirmation of those 50-50 results. No point in reading them to you guys.
8159. Congratulations.
Unless you bought a ticket and went home, although I doubt that. Why would you want to miss this?
Make your way to the foyer as quickly as you can.
Get play restarted, and back inside to Shattuck. Shattuck collides with Russ Moyer. His helmet comes off, he has to skate straight back to the bench after that collision. And the puck takes a deflection into the crowd there. And it looks as though, yeah, the fan's got himself a souvenir. Thankfully no first aid required on that occasion, unlike the poor girl that got the puck earlier. 8:19 to go of this third period. The face-off just in front of the Fife zone down the inside left. With Clan shooting right to left. Wall of Fame end to Zamboni end. Referee Chris Wells didn't see that one coming. That rebounded off him. Thankfully not too serious. Not that he would have got any sympathy from the fans here, of course. Clan trying to get puck out of their own zone at the moment, but Zins feeds it back in, but Sullivan retrieves, but it's the cross ice pass, but now to Brooks. Brooks tries to control it, that puck bouncing in front of him, does well, ties in with Schofield, chance from Brooks just over the bar. Clan now back in neutral ice, Oslanski makes the entry down the left hand side, but Zins comes across to try and stop him at the boards. Brooks the end of one there from Berzins, he goes straight after him there, Brooks. This is where it gets interesting. Brooks is looking to do something with Berzins here, and both men get into it. Brooks swinging in some punches, he loses the helmet, drops the gloves out, and both men topple to the ice. Brooks wasn't happy with that challenge from Berzins, he wasn't happy. The play continued, Brooks went to confront his man. I would say a draw on that one, but the home fan, both sets of fans, on their feet. 7:05 to go of the third period, and both players will set out for fighting. Brooks was far from happy with that challenge from Berzins, nearly took him off his feet, but the puck moved a little bit further up the ice, the puck was jammed in at the boards. Brooks went for Berzins just to basically show he wasn't happy with that, and the fight broke out. I would say level on that one. So, 7:05 to go. Brooks and Berzins both taking a seat.
Penalties to be served in the Nairnbrook and OSC sponsored penalty box.
So whether
on the Fife Flyers,
whether that helps the Clan fans in terms of helping the team get back on some kind of keel here, try and help them get a goal back.
5 minutes for fighting. Penalties time, 52 minutes and 55 seconds.
Well, 7:05 to go.
42 of the Flyers, 49 of the Clan, each receive 5 minutes for fighting. Penalties time.
And the face-off to the right of Andy Isles' goal. Tyler Shattuck in the centre there with Peter LeBlanc. And it's Fife that have it. They send it up the far end. Healers chases after it. Seskin just in front of him. And the Clan D-man just comes out of it with the puck on that occasion. Seskon leaves it for him back. Shattuck tries one from the wide left. Isles making the save. Well, as things stand, it would be Fife Flyers' fifth consecutive win against Brayhead Clan this season. Their sixth in official competition against the Clan. They won the last league game between the two teams at the end of last season. Six in a row, that's pretty good going. Clan had eight before it, so Fife creeping up on that one. Clan will want to end that soon. That was a one-timer from Bert. Isles just moves it away. Clan take the chance here. Sullivan, a deflection off Hamalainen, just takes it wide. Clan again look to build on this. It's Burt. He's got Sullivan at the blue line. Inside left, Sullivan. The pad save from Isles. Comes back to Sullivan again at the blue line as it's moved away. Schofield touches it away from Bloodoff. He's down the right hand side for Brayhead Clan. Has to go behind the goal. The goal moves. And I think you can hear the reaction from the home fans, what they think of it. As that goal moved at the crucial opportunity, Schofield had moved himself just behind the goal, looking to play the puck back in. And the goal comes off the mooring again.
Right, the draw has now been made in the Yo Sushi 50-50 draw. The prize tonight, a fantastic 1,250.
Well, as things stand, five Flyers would be unbeaten in their last seven. An incredible record to see them up there.
1-1-9-8.
And of course, they would move 4 points clear at the top of the Gardner Conference as well. But the fact Fife are up there with games in hand, I think, is a real impressive thing there. You see them up there, they're up challenging, that's for sure. There's Peacock. It's getting a little bit feisty between these two teams in the final stages. I've seen Brooks and Verzins drop the gloves and go at it. Into the final 6 minutes, Haywood. Tries to move away from Ian Young. They're in the board at the opposite corner. Zamboni end at section 8. Far side from our position here at Brayhead Arena. Charlie Mosey up the inside right. Now it's Gauthier moves into the centre. Jorgensen tries one. Nye hits the deck, but the puck is saved by him. And it's Cameron Burt. Has he got an option? He turns. He's down the right-hand side towards the corner. Embach. It's the shot, comes off Isles' pads and deflected up. Gutwald with the retrieval. Again, the action coming in down the right hand side, just next to Fife Flyers' bench. Isles makes the cover. Well, Fife's next game, they take on Belfast on Tuesday in the Challenge Cup quarter final. Second leg, 3-3 after the first leg. The 16th of December. That's going to be an interesting one when Fife make the trip over there. But for Clan, no action for them until Saturday and the visit of Manchester Storm, 7 p.m. on Saturday. Tickets available at brayheadclan.com. Fife win the draw on that occasion as we come up on the 15-minute mark of this period. Five to go, just over that. The whistle blows again as icing is called. Well, as things stand, it looks as though those goals from Shane Stockton and Danny Gauthier will be the difference for the Flyers. 5 minutes to go, but a goal from the home team, a goal will settle this game one way or another. One from Clan will get them back into it and set up a grandstand finale. There's a bit of an error there in the face-off. A goal for Flyers would kill the game off completely. Looking from them, two more points. And you have to say, they're having a great season this year, the Fife Flyers. Plan though, work in progress, a lot of transition. Brand new team, brand new coach. Well, LeBlanc and Bjorklund collide at the far side, just in front of the Flyers bench. Gutwald leaves it wide for Embach. Helis to Finucci down Fife's right hand side as they have to retreat back the way. Isaacs has it just behind Isles' goal. Isles been impressive for Fife this year. There's Lansky now for the Clan. Through the centre, Clan make the entry. It's Peacock. Peacock tries one just wide. There's Lansky again back to. In back, Oslanski caused a bit of a scramble in front of the crease there. Adam Brace falls down. I'm not really sure what caused that, if he was tripped or he tripped over something. Shaver, I think, was involved in that. Anyway, play continues. Jorgensen feeds it forward, comes all the way down. It takes a touch, there's no icing on this one. And Gutwald, 3:45 to go. Clan have to get a goal, they need it any time soon, they really do.
Sullivan tries to make the stop, but again Fife in full flow. Blood off for Mosey. That's high, lands behind Nye's goal, just in front of the plexi. Home side look for this, it's Schofield, makes entry through the centre. Tries to do something incredibly clever, but Ian Young having none of it. Tried to drag the puck through his legs and create an opening. Young stood his ground brilliantly. And once again. Well, I think a lot of reaction we saw from Fife fans last night was that Clan were a better team than what they were back in October. And it looks like it's going to be an empty netter, but it's called back. Thought it was called back. Blundhoff seemed to ease up there. Indeed not. The empty net goal. Nye was pulled. Fife made the breakthrough, blood off, clean through, and finishes off. The way he eased off there, I thought he'd been called back. Obviously not, he tapped into the empty net, and that's 3-0 for Fife Flyers. As the fans in that corner celebrate, they will go third place tonight, the Fife Flyers for Clan. A third straight defeat since the turn of the year. Losing to Dundee on Tuesday.
Third goal for the Fife
and in Fife last night.
Goal scored unassisted by number 10. Evan
and blood off gets his 10th point against Brayhead Clan this year. His 9th goal.
Third goal for the Flyers, an empty net goal.
A good start for blood off.
Unassisted.
Who overall?
57-10.
This is 28th point of the season. 19 goals in 27 league games for the Fife Flyers. And that's the singing of the Fife Flyers fans in the corner, rightly so. Their team 3-0 up and on the verge of victory with 2:20 to go. You see face off on the spot just in front of the Fife zone on the on this side, actually, on our side, the inside right from Fife's point of view. Flyers will take it easy, I'm sure, for the next couple of minutes. I don't think there's any danger of them throwing away a 3-goal lead with 2 minutes to go. And the collapse of epic proportions, and, well, we haven't seen that from Fife all season.
Icing, sponsored by Goldstone Wealth Management.
But they'll keep those bragging rights going, at least until the next meeting. Five in a row this season, six altogether, stretching back to the end of last season for Todd Dutiam's men. Face off in front of section eight, the Zamboni end to the left of Andy Isle's goal. And it's called back, 2:03 to go. Well, Brayhead back at home next Saturday. Manchester Storm come here, they'll be looking for a reaction to that one. For sure, we'll get the post-match thoughts of both coaches post-game. Bjorklund. Beats it in, that's a goal from Bjorklund. Can't get one back, 1:59 to go. Flicks up from the wide right position, sends it in diagonally. And Isles has beaten the shutout prevented. Clan get one on the board, 3-1. .159 to go. And face-off will restart this game for the final couple of minutes.
Clan goals are sponsored by Brayhead Radio Car.
Fife win the draw, comes all the way back to Isles, Isaacs, plans. To Jorgensen.
Scott West Credit Services sponsor.
Dumps it down for LeBlanc. Is this
Christopher Gertler?
LeBlanc tried to cut it back for Mosey. Doesn't quite come up for him. Sullivan.
The goal goes to the MPMH sponsor, number 20.
Decides to Burt. Hamalainen on the inside left. Hamalainen, the Finn. 8 minutes
and 1 second.
Has to turn.
Opening goal for the Clan. Scored by.
He's at the blue line. Finds Sullivan at the opposite end. Sullivan tries to play it and takes the deflection. Nye is pulled again. Has Clan go for it? They've got one. Can they get a second one? Well, that would set up one hell of a finale. But there's very little time left.
Clan trying to keep it in Fife ice at the moment. 1:10 remains of this third period. Clan get a goal back. Is it too little, too late? It looks a tall order. As we look at it, scrambles Lewis Hammerlinen. Almost managed to shovel it in there. Isles flat out trying to stop him there. But Fife recover as Clan continue to play it around. They've got the extra skater. Playing it around as though it's a power play. And play stops again. Face off will take place in the circle to the right of Andy Isles' goal. At the Zamboni end to our left as we look down across Brayhead Arena. Hammerlinen in the circle there. 47.3 seconds to go. Clan take the draw. Burt has it trapped around his feet. Healy snicks it off him. Clan still have that unguarded goal. Has Blood off. Gets the other one. Blood off with his second goal of the night. And for the fourth time in five fixtures, Evan Bloodoff scores at least two goals against Brayhead Clan. Another empty net goal to make it 4-1. Just when Clan was starting to... Just when they got something on the board, there was a glimmer of hope, and I say a glimmer. But in the end,
fourth goal for Fife Flyers and
get the opportunity
goal
and take it.
By number 10,
as Evan Bloodoff gets his second of the game.
By 74, Liam Healis. Time of the goal, 59 minutes.
And Healis gets his 11th
seconds
point of the season fourth against Clan as well.
An empty net goal, scored by 10.
His ninth assist.
By 74, time
sent
of the goal,
in
59.
By McKenzie, just goes wide. Plenty of fans making their way towards the exits here at Brayhead Arena. Mostly Clan fans. Some Fife Flyers fans making their way out as well, of course. 18.2 seconds. And they face off in front of the Clan defensive zone. Just in front of us. And this, the left-hand side from Brayhead's point of view as they play it forward into the last 10 seconds. The whistle blows again. Seems like the longest 2 minutes we've had. Just all sorts of stoppages and stuff. Well, Fife are now unbeaten in their last seven as they head to that Challenge Cup tie in Belfast on Tuesday. Interesting to get the thoughts of Fife ahead of that one. Any Fife fans listening, reaction from Fife will appear on the Elite League social media accounts a little bit later. And the buzzer goes to signal the end of this game. The Fife Flyers make it 5 in a row against Brayhead Clan this season. 6 in a row in total. A 4-1 victory. And it's disappointment for Brayhead. 1 point to show from their weekend. For Fife, a 4-point weekend that takes them up to third place. Goals coming from Shane Stockton, Danny Gauthier, and two empty net goals from Evan Bloodoff, securing victory for Fife. All Clan had in response was one from Christopher Bjorklund. Well, as the fans stream out of Brayhead Arena, thank you so much for listening to Clan Radio Live tonight. We hope you've enjoyed what you've heard. I'm sure if you're from Fife, you will have enjoyed
yes,
that, that's for sure.
Next home game,
and Clan are back on home ice next Saturday when they take on Manchester Storm. 7 o'clock face-off, tickets available on BrayheadClan.com. Thank you again for listening. The